Functional memory gland is a characteristic of a female mammals, and the memory glands are paired structure and they contain glandular tissue and variable amount of fat. So fat amount is supposed to be variable. That is the reason behind the variable or the difference in the sizes of the breasts among females. It is not more milk or extra or less milk. It is amount of the fat which is variable. The glandular tissue of each breast is divisible into 15 to 20 mammary lobes, containing clusters of the cells called as the alveoli. So mammary lobes are made up of cells which synthesize milk, and those cells are called as the alveoli cells. And cells of the alveoli secrete milk, which is stored in the cavity of the alveoli called as lumen. Now the alveoli open into mammary tubule. Now this sequence you have to by heart or learn. From the alveoli the milk goes into cavity. From cavity it goes into the mammary tubule. From tubule it goes to the mammary duct, and from many mammary ducts it joins to form a common ampulla which connects to the lactiferous duct. So remember, mammary tubule, then mammary duct, then we have the mammary ampulla, and after ampulla it goes into lactiferous duct, which open into the nipple of the breast gland. Now the next is the gametogenesis. The primary sex organs, the testes in the male and ovaries in the female, they produce gametes, the sperm and the ovum respectively, by the process of gametogenesis. In testes, the immature male germ cells produce sperms by spermatogenesis that begins at puberty. So spermatogenesis starts at puberty, and then the spermatogonia present inside the wall of the seminiferous tubule. Remember, we discussed in the previous pages regarding the male germ cells. So spermatogonia are the mother cells or diploid cells. They are present in the wall of the seminiferous tubule. They multiply by mitosis and increase their number. So initially they undergo mitosis to increase their number. Then each of these spermatogonia, because they are diploid, they contain 46 chromosomes. Some of them will develop into primary spermatocyte, not all of them, because some will be stored for the future. That's why sperm formation is a continuous process up to the death of a person. There could be decrease in the sperm formation as we age, as a male person ages, but the reality is sperm formation continues, because some cells only undergo differentiation into primary spermatocyte. Others will be stored for future. So those which become differentiated into primary spermatocyte, they periodically undergo meiosis. And as they undergo meiosis, they will remember the meiosis has two step, meiosis first and second. So the spermatogonia are diploid, primary spermatocytes are diploid. Now when they start entering into meiosis, a primary spermatocyte completes the primary spermatocyte completes its first meiotic division, mean reductional division, leading to the formation of two equal haploid cells called as the secondary spermatocyte. So secondary spermatocytes are the first haploid cells formed in this process, and these cells have only 23 number of chromosomes, and then because they are equal in size and they are haploid, now they divide once again. And the secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiotic division to produce four equal haploid spermatids. Now these spermatids carry again 23 number of chromosomes, and spermatids are transformed into the spermatozoa by the process called as spermiogenesis. So now these spermatids are round cell. They have to turn into a tail bearing long cell, which are called as the sperms or spermatozoa. So this change is not a division, it is only differentiation. So the spermatids undergo the process of transformation or differentiation into sperms, and this process is called as spermiogenesis. Please remember, spermiogenesis is the last step of spermatogenesis. Now once spermiogenesis is over, the heads will become embedded into the Sertoli cell. The nutrition will be given by the Sertoli cell. So Sertoli cells provide nutrition, and once the nutrition is done to its maximum, finally these already fed, because their hunger is over, they are being nutritionally filled. Now these cells will be removed from the seminiferous tubule. They will detach from Sertoli cell and they will come out of the seminiferous tubule and go into the rete testes. This process of removal of the sperms from the seminiferous tubule is called as spermiation. So there are three things here: spermatogenesis, spermiogenesis and spermiation. Don't get confused. Next is that the spermatogenesis starts at the age of puberty due to the significant increase in the secretion of GnRH. You have learned in the 11th class. This, if you recall, is a hypothalamic hormone. The increased level of GnRH will act on the anterior lobe of pituitary, and then stimulates the secretion of two gonadotropins, LH and FSH. LH acts on the Leydig cell, remember L for L. LH acts on Leydig cell and stimulates the process of formation and secretion of the androgen. And androgen in turn stimulates the process of the sperm formation. FSH acts on the Sertoli cell. F stands for feeding, so Sertoli cells provide feeding. And then the Sertoli cells not just provide feeding, but they also release certain factors which are required for the process of spermiogenesis. We will talk about from this page in the next class.